I'm Akila Maheshwari from NAMI India. We started in a small way as a website in 2001, and now we have approximately 10 branches all over India, where we are mainly working for those afflicted by mental illness and their related people who are working in the field of mental health, which is the carers, the social workers, the psychiatrists, the counselors, and the whole public health and private health system as a whole in the field of mental health. And while we work for those with mental illness, we don't believe that mental health issues only happen to those with mental illness. They can happen to the general population also in a temporary manner. So whatever I talk to you related to mental illness also applies in a general way to people in the general population. What we'll do in this thing is we are not going to be having any kind of presentation. We run the mental aerobics program. All of you have heard of physical aerobics. Physical aerobics is what you do. You have to do exercises to your body regularly. Why do you do that?
Keep your body healthy.
Absolutely, to keep your body healthy. But nobody has given paid that much attention to the mind. We have not realized that our mind is becoming slowly and slowly unhealthy, and then we cannot do anything about it before it is too late. A lot of people sink into depression, a lot of people fall ill, or they have difficult times in their life, and it's because of a lot of things which was affecting their mind. And we believe that just like you can have a healthy body and you maintain it through physical fitness, in the same way you can have a healthy mind by simply doing some mental aerobic exercises and constantly working on your mind to make it fit. And this is particularly more relevant for those who have mental illnesses. Because what happens in a mental illness? What happens to the mind? Yeah, the mind has lost control. The subconscious has taken over. And the mind is thinking a lot of things which is causing either depression, or it is causing bipolar disorder, or it's causing attention disorder, or it is causing schizophrenia, or all sorts of disorders. And if a person only relies on medication, we do agree. When you have a heart problem, do you only take medication or you do walking also?
Walking.
Absolutely. So, in the same way, when you have a mental illness or a psychiatric disorder, you rely on your medication, yes, but you can also embark on a mental aerobics program to keep your mind mentally fit. And this is, do you do exercises for a year and stop? No, you keep on walking or keep on doing it as long as you're alive, right? In the same way, for the mental aerobics program, the exercises what I'm telling you are to be done on a regular basis, constantly, so that you are mentally fit. And we are going to do one of the exercises which is overcoming or fighting your fears, subconscious or otherwise. See, fear is one of the greatest enemies we encounter. All of us have a fear of something or other, and that when that fear grips you, what happens? It's a serious threat to our mental health. So let us start with this exercise where we are going to identify our fears. All of us have some fears. One of my fears is, let me share with you, will I be fit? Will I be agile? Will I be mentally healthy in my old age? I'm 50 now. Will I be able to be fit when I'm 80? Walk around, be active when I'm 90, so that I'm not dependent on someone. I'm not a burden on someone. This is my fear. What is the point of such a fear? Isn't it a little foolish? I'm 50 now and I'm thinking like 30 years down the line, what is going to happen, and I'm going to obsess over it. Yeah, it's a fear. So in the same way, I'm going to share with you this exercise. The first thing is, we all have fears. And people who have mental illness, you can share that with him. People, you'll get a copy. You can take it back with you. We are going to be doing these programs in Hindi and Marathi, so that people I'm translating this, and so that people who speak Hindi, who are poorer, and who speak Marathi, who are poorer, can participate in this program. As you can understand, doing this exercise doesn't cost much money. You don't have to join a club. Yeah. Yeah. So, the first thing about fight your fears. If anybody who's been close to people who have mental illness, do you know that they have fears? Have you experienced that they have a lot of fears? Can you share any of the fears which you or your friend or your relative with mental illness has?
I know a person who's had a problematic childhood, a difficult one. Parents passed away at a very young age. And that insecurity has been inbuilt in the subconscious mind. And even after reaching a position where a person has had it, you know, the fear is that insecurity is still present.
What is the insecurity?
What if I lose my spouse or something like that?
Okay, that's an insecurity. That's an irrational fear. From your perspective, you think that fear is not really warranted, right?
No, actually, we don't know. No one knows what's going to happen.
Yeah.
So having a fear like that is just like torturing you.
It's like torturing you. Absolutely. It's a stress to your mental health. He wants to share something?
I had a father who went through Alzheimer's. And
that's not funny. Yeah.
Not funny at all.
Okay. It's all right.
And I went through and into the day. And I had a neighbor who went through a very active person. Went into very serious Alzheimer's.
Yes.
And with my father, at least, his organs gave away every one little organ.
Except the heart, okay.
Today, I have a fear that I get it or not.
That you'll get Alzheimer's or not, yes, you have a fear.
Everything that I want to get it.
Yes, I understand.
So I believe this is the worst thing to happen anybody.
Yeah, but the fear is also not good if it's preying on your mind. Yeah. The fear is real. We are not saying that the fears are unfounded. Bad things have happened to people. But what I'm saying is, if we are going to allow these fears to overcome us or take over, it's going to be a torture, as he said. He shared, the torture or the fear that this is going to happen is something which is terrible. So the first thing I want you to all list in the exercise sheet, you don't have to share it with everyone, this is personal and it's takeaway. List, if you look at the third question, just list down, I've said list any three fears. List at least two fears at the bottom. At the bottom, the last. There's one, two, and three. Yeah. Yeah. I put, one. Yeah, here. You can list one single fear. Right at the bottom, I put one. List any one single fear which you feel has been affecting you deeply. Any one fear. Right at the bottom, I put one. You can list one.
Nobody gets a fear.
That's very good. If you don't have any fears, it's good. You can share a fear of your relative then. If you don't have any fears, I think that's very good. Excellent. But then you can share with me a fear which one of your loved ones has. Okay? Honest about your fear. See, everybody at some point or the other has a fear. There's nothing wrong with it. But the problem with fear is if this subconscious fear or the fear becomes excessive, then it becomes a problem. It becomes a problem and it becomes highly irrational. And it starts affecting your activities, your thoughts. For example, I know of a person who thought he was going to die. It's a very strange story. And his fear became so excessive. And some astrologer told him, you're going to die, which was all not at all true. Okay? The fear became so excessive that he transferred. he already had some kind of fear, and that was so the fear increased.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. So he transferred all his assets on his wife's name. Why did he do that? Because he thought, now I'm going to die, I don't want any problem to happen. By a quirk of fate, he didn't die. But 10 years later, his wife got cancer and she died. So he spent another year and a half transferring all the assets back in his name. So at that point of time, that fear was quite not rational. But he was sick. And added to him being sick, the fact that the astrologer told him that you won't live long made him have that fear. What I'm saying is, at that point of time, that fear tortures you. That fear tortures you, and it's for you to now that you have listed your fear. It's for us. Let us look at the next step. The first step is what? I know a lot of past fears, which we had a lot of past fears, and when you look back on them, you think they were really irrational. Like, I'll give you a very interesting example of a fear. Some young people here, some of them can have a fear that I won't get a job. Right? I'm not going to be able to get a job because they failed in 2 or 3 interviews. But at the end of it, they did get a job. So that fear was really irrational. Do you agree with me, young man?
Definitely.
That's a very typical fear. And just because you didn't pass in 2 or 3 interviews, it doesn't mean you won't get a job. And you also have to realize the number of people applying for a job in India is very large. So the number of people being rejected is more than the number of people being accepted. The reverse is true for people who are 50 and above. Who will give me a job? We are too old, even though we are capable. Because now, with the risk of dying too early, you have the risk of living too long. What is the risk of living too long? You are 60, you are retired, and with all the good medical facilities and with health library, we may all live very, very long. And what are we going to do for so many years if we are not going to earn an income? And a lot of people in India don't have a pension. So if life is going to be very difficult and people are not going to give us jobs, so what are we going to do? So,
How can they survive?
They will survive. They have to overcome their fears. That's just one of the aspects. Right? Given the fact that 50% of the population is below 30 years of age, naturally they are going to say that we should be given the preference to work. Otherwise we are going to be unemployed. If it's all a conflict of interest, if he or me are employed, then there's a possibility that somebody below 30 doesn't get that opportunity. I'm not saying experience doesn't play. So let's come back. We have the past fears which didn't come true. Can any of you share a fear which you had in the past which didn't come true? Yes? Any fear you had in the past which didn't come true? She's sharing, yeah? You had a fear of contracting a certain illness. It was unfounded. Okay. Anybody else?
We find that most of our fears are imaginary. They don't materialize.
Absolutely.
We imagine, but they don't.
Absolutely. So when we know that most of our fears are imaginary, most of them don't materialize, we can make a game plan to attack those fears. Right? And our current fears also, we can make a game plan to attack those fears. So how can we attack these fears? Before I share with you my